Welcome students, in this unit we will study theory of equations part 4. In this session we study the definition of reciprocal equation. We also familiarize with some methods for solving a reciprocal equation. We will see that to determine the nature of sum of the roots of a polynomial equation, it is not always necessary to solve the equation. We describe Newton's method of approximation to find approximate roots of a given polynomial equation. Horner's process is also described. Reciprocal equations. Definition: reciprocal equation. If an equation remains unaltered when x is changed into its reciprocal, it is called a reciprocal equation. An example of a reciprocal equation is 2x^4 − 3x³ + 100x² − 3x + 2 = 0. Definition: standard reciprocal equation. A reciprocal equation of the first type and even degree is called a standard reciprocal equation. It has the following form: a0(x^2m + a1)(x^2m−1)+etc+am−1)(x^m+1)+am(x^m+am−1)(x^m−1)+etc+am(x+n0)=0. An example of a standard reciprocal equation is 2x^4 − 3x³ + 100x² − 3x + 2 = 0. Remark: it is obvious that if alpha is a root of a reciprocal equation, then 1/α is also root. Example 1. Solve the reciprocal equation 60x^4 − 736x³ + 1433x² − 736x + 60 = 0. Solution: the given is a reciprocal equation and dividing throughout by x square, we obtain 60 × x² + 1/x² − 736 × x + 1/x + 1433 = 0. Equation 1. Now, let z equal to x plus 1 by x, then z square equal to x plus 1 by x whole square, which is equal to x² + 2 + 1/x². So, that x² + 1/x² = z² − 2, and hence equation 1 becomes 60 × z² − 2 − 736z + 1433 = 0. That is 6 × z − 13 × 10 × z − 101 = 0. This gives z = 13/6 or z = 101/10. That is x + 1/x = 13/6 or x + 1/x = 101/10. That is 6x² − 13x + 6 = 0 or 10x² − 101x + 10 = 0. Solving the two quadratic equations, we obtain x = 2/3, 3/2, 10, 1/10, and they are the roots of the given equation. Example 2. Solve 6x^5 + 11x^4 − 33x² + 11x + 6 = 0. Solution: by inspection, 1 root is −1. Dividing by x + 1, we obtain 6x^4 + 5x³ − 38x² + 5x + 6 = 0. A reciprocal equation. Dividing the last obtained equation by x square and grouping the terms, we obtain 6 × x² + 1/x² + 5 × x + 1/x − 38 = 0. If z equal to x plus 1 by x, this equation becomes 6 × z² − 2 + 5z − 38 = 0. 6z² + 5z − 50 = 0. z = 5/2 or z = −10/3, and x is given by x + 1/x = 5/2 − 10/3. Hence, x = 2, 1/2, −3, −1/3. Hence, the roots are −1, 2, 1/2, −3, −1/3. Example 3. Solve 3x^5 − 10x^4 − 3x³ − 3x² − 10x + 3 = 0. Solution: 1 root is −1. Dividing by x + 1, we obtain 3x^4 − 13x³ + 10x² − 13x + 3 = 0. Dividing by x square and grouping the terms, we obtain 3 × x² + 1/x² − 13 × x + 1/x + 10 = 0. If z equal to x plus 1 by x, this becomes 3 × z² − 2 − 13z + 10 = 0. That is 3z² − 13z + 4 = 0. Hence, z = 4 or z = 1/3, and x is given by x plus 1 by x = 4 or x plus 1 by x = 1/3. Hence, x equal to 2 plus or minus root 3 1 by 2 into 1 plus or minus I root 35. Hence, the roots are minus 1, 2 plus or minus root 3 1 by 2 into 1 plus or minus I root 35. Nature of roots. To determine the nature of sum of the roots of a polynomial equation, it is not always necessary to solve it. For instance, the truth of the following statements will be readily admitted. 1. If the coefficients of a polynomial equation are all positive, the equation has no positive roots. For example, the equation x raised to 4 plus 3 x square plus 3 equal to 0 cannot have a positive root. 2. If the coefficients of the even powers of x are all of one sign and the coefficients of the odd powers are all of the opposite sign, the equation has no negative root. Thus, for example, the equation minus x raised to 8 plus x raised to 7 plus x raised to 5 minus 2 x raised to 4 plus x cube minus 3 x square plus 7 x minus 3 equal to 0 cannot have a negative root. 3. If the equation contains only even powers of x and the coefficients are all of the same sign, the equation has no real root. Thus, for example, the equation minus x raised to 8 minus 2 x raised to 4 minus 3 x square minus 3 equal to 0 cannot have a real root. 4. If the equation contains only odd powers of x and the coefficients are all of the same sign, the equation has no real root except x equal to 0. Thus, the equation x raised to 7 plus x raised to 5 plus 3 x cube plus 8 x equal to 0 has no real root except x equal to 0. Suppose that the signs of the terms in a polynomial are plus, plus, minus, minus, plus, minus, 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 plus, minus, plus, minus. The number of changes of sign is 7. We shall show that if this polynomial is multiplied by a binomial corresponding to a positive root whose signs are plus, minus, there will be at least one more changes of sign in the product than in the original polynomial. Writing down only the signs of the terms in the multiplication, we have the following. Plus, plus, minus, minus, plus, minus, 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 plus, minus, plus, minus, plus, minus, plus, plus, minus, minus, plus, minus, 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 plus, minus, plus, minus, 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 plus, plus, minus, plus, 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 minus, plus, minus, plus. That is plus, plus or minus, minus, plus or minus, plus, minus, plus or minus, plus or minus, plus, minus, plus, minus, plus. Here in the last line, the ambiguous sign plus or minus is placed wherever there are two different signs to be added. Here we see that in the product, 1. An ambiguity replaces each continuation of sign in the original polynomial. 2. The signs before and after an ambiguity or set of ambiguities are unlike. 3. A change of sign is introduced at the end. Let us take the most unfavorable case, that is the case where the number of changes of sign is less. And suppose that all the ambiguities are replaced by continuations, then the sign of the terms becomes plus, plus, minus, minus, plus, minus, 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 plus, minus, plus, minus, plus. The number of changes of sign is 8. We conclude that if a polynomial is multiplied by a binomial corresponding to a positive root whose signs are plus, minus, there will be at least one more change of sign in the product than in the original polynomial. If then we suppose the factors corresponding to the negative and imaginary roots to be already multiplied together, each factor x minus a corresponding to a positive root introduces at least one change of sign. Therefore, no equation can have more positive roots than it has changes of sign. Again, the roots of the equation f of minus x equal to 0 are equal to those of f of x equal to 0, but opposite to them in sign. Therefore, the negative roots of f of x equal to 0 are the positive roots of f of minus x equal to 0. But the number of these positive roots cannot exceed the number of changes of sign in f of minus x. That is, the number of negative roots of f of x equal to 0 cannot exceed the number of changes in sign in f of minus x. All the above observations are included in the following result, known as Descartes' rule of signs. An equation f of x equal to 0 cannot have more positive roots than there are changes of sign in f of x, and cannot have more negative roots than there are changes of sign in f of minus x. Example 4. Discuss the nature of roots of the equation x raised to 9 plus 5 x raised to 8 minus x cube plus 7 x plus 2 equal to 0. Solution. Here there are two changes of sign, therefore, there are at most two positive roots. Again, f of minus x equal to minus x raised to 9 plus 5 x raised to 8 plus x cube minus 7 x plus 2. And here there are 3 changes of sign. Therefore, the given equation has at most 3 negative roots. And therefore, it must have at least 4 imaginary roots. Particular cases of Taylor's theorem. We now recall Taylor's theorem of the differential calculus. It is a method or formula by which we can expand a given function in ascending integral powers of x. The method or formula is based on the following assumptions. 1. The expansion of the function in ascending powers of the variable is possible. 2. All the higher derivatives of the function exist and finite. 3. The infinite series is convergent. Theorem 1. Taylor's theorem. The Taylor's series is f of x plus h equal to f of x plus h into f dash x plus h square by 2 factorial f double dash x plus etcetera plus h raised to n by n factorial f n x plus etcetera, where h is small and also provided that the series converges. We now give a particular case of Taylor's theorem. Theorem 2. The value of f of x plus h when f of x is a polynomial function of x is given by f of x plus h equal to f of x plus h into f dash x plus h square by 2 factorial f double dash x plus h cube by 3 factorial f triple dash x plus etcetera h raised to n by n factorial f n x. Equation number 2. Proof. Let f of x equal to p naught x raised to n plus p 1 x raised to n minus 1 plus p 2 x raised to n minus 2 plus etcetera plus p n minus 1 x plus p n. Then f of x plus h equal to p naught into x plus h raised to n plus p 1 into x plus h raised to n minus 1 plus p 2 into x plus h raised to n minus 2 plus etcetera plus p n minus 1 x plus h plus p n. Expanding each term and arranging the result in ascending powers of h, we have p naught x raised to n plus p 1 x raised to n minus 1 plus p 2 x raised to n minus 2 plus etcetera plus p n minus 1 x plus p n plus h into n p naught x raised to n minus 1 plus n minus 1 p 1 x raised to n minus 2 plus etcetera plus p n minus 1 plus h square by 2 factorial into n minus 1 p naught x raised to n minus 2 plus n minus 1 into n minus 2 p 1 x raised to n minus 3 plus etcetera plus 2 p n minus 2 plus etcetera plus h raised to n by n factorial n into n minus 1 into n minus 2 into etcetera 2 into 1 into p naught. The above gives f of x plus h equal to f of x plus h into f dash x plus h square by 2 factorial f double dash x plus h cube by 3 factorial f triple dash x plus etcetera plus h raised to n by n factorial f n x. Remark. Replacing h by minus h, the above gives f of x minus h equal to f of x minus h into f dash x plus h square by 2 factorial f double dash x minus h cube by 3 factorial f triple dash x plus etcetera plus minus 1 raised to n h raised to n by n factorial f n x. The function f of x plus h is evidently symmetrical with respect to x and h. Hence, f of x plus h equal to f of h plus x into f dash h plus h square by 2 factorial f double dash h plus h cube by 3 factorial f triple dash x plus etcetera plus x raised to n by n factorial f n h. Here the expressions f dash h, f double dash h, x, f triple dash x, etcetera denote the results obtained by writing h in the place of x in the successive derived functions f dash x, f double dash x, f triple dash x, etcetera. Example 5. Let f of x equal to 2 x raised to 4 minus s cube minus 2 x square plus 5 x minus 1. Find the value of f of x plus 3. Solution. We use the formula given in equation 2 with h equal to 3. Here f of x equal to 2 x raised to 4 minus x cube minus 2 x square plus 5 x minus 1. So, that f of 3 is equal to 131. F dash x equal to 8 x cube minus 3 x square minus 4 x plus 5. So, that f dash 3 equal to 182. F double dash x by 2 factorial is equal to 12 x square minus 3 x minus 2. So, that f double dash 3 by 2 factorial equal to 97. F triple dash x by 3 factorial is equal to 8 x minus 1. So, that f triple dash 3 by 3 factorial equal to 23. F 4 x by 4 factorial equal to 2. So, that f 4 3 by 4 factorial equal to 2. Thus, f of x plus 3 equal to 2 x raised to 4 plus 23 x cube plus 97 x square plus 182 x plus 131. Newton's method of approximation. Suppose that one root of the equation f of x equal to 0 is nearly equal to a, where the correct value of the root be a plus y, so that f of a plus y equal to 0, but by Taylor's theorem of the differential calculus we obtain f of a plus y equal to f of a plus y into f dash a plus terms in higher powers of y. Since a is an approximate value of the root y is small, so the second and higher powers of y will be much smaller. Neglecting them, we see the approximately f of a plus y into f dash a equal to 0, hence y equal to minus f of a by f dash a. This determines y, which added to a gives a better value of the root. Taking a plus y as the new approximate value of the root, the above process can be repeated to find a still better value of the root and so on. Example 6. Using Newton's method of approximation, find the approximate root of x cube plus x square plus x minus 100 equal to 0, which is approximately equal to 4. Solution. Step 1. Take a equal to 4. Now, to get a value of y, we proceed as follows. F of x equal to x cube plus x square plus x minus 100 and f dash x equal to 3x square plus 2x plus 1. Hence, f of 4 equal to 4 cube plus 4 square plus 4 minus 100, which is equal to minus 16, and f dash 4 is equal to 3 into 4 square plus 2 into 4 plus 1 equal to 57. Thus, y equal to minus f of a by f dash a, which is equal to minus f of 4 by f dash 4, which is equal to minus of minus 16 by 57, which is equal to 0.3. Hence, the root is approximately equal to a plus y equal to 4 plus 0.3 equal to 4.3. Step 2. Now, to get a better approximation, we take 4.3 as new a, f of a equal to f of 4.3, which is equal to 2.3, and f dash a equal to f dash of 4.3, which is equal to 65.1. Hence, y equal to minus f of a by f dash a, which is equal to minus f of 4.3 by f dash of 4.3, which is equal to minus 2.3 by 65.1, which is equal to minus 0.036. Hence, a better approximation to the root is given by a plus y equal to 4.3 minus 0.036, which is equal to 4.264. The process can be continued, but we stop in two steps and accept 4.264 as an approximate root. Horner's process. Let f of x equal to p naught x raised to n plus p 1 x raised to n minus 1 plus etcetera plus p n minus 1 x plus p n. Put x equal to y plus h and suppose that f of x then becomes the polynomial q naught y raised to n plus q 1 y raised to n minus 1 plus etcetera plus q n minus 1 y plus q n. Now, y equal to x minus h, and hence we have the identity p naught x raised to n plus p 1 x raised to n minus 1 plus etcetera plus p n minus 1 x plus p n equal to q naught into x minus h raised to n plus q 1 x minus h raised to n minus 1 plus etcetera plus q n minus 1 into x minus h plus q n. Therefore, q n is the remainder found by dividing f of x by x minus h. Also, the quotient arising from the division is q naught into x minus h raised to n minus 1 plus q 1 into x minus h raised to n minus 2 plus etcetera plus q n minus 1. Similarly, q n minus 1 is the remainder found by dividing the last expression by x minus h. Also, the quotient arising from the division is q naught into x minus h raised to n minus 2 plus q 1 into x minus h raised to n minus 3 plus etcetera plus q n minus 2 and so on. Thus, q n minus 1 etcetera may be found, and the last quotient is q naught and is obviously equal to p naught. Example 7. Using Horner's process, find the new polynomial as a result of changing x into x plus 3 in the expression 2 x raised to 4 minus x cube minus 2 x square plus 5 x minus 1. Solution. Here, f of x equal to 2 x raised to 4 minus x cube minus 2 x square plus 5 x minus 1 equal to p naught x raised to 4 plus p 1 x cube plus p 2 x square plus p 3 x plus p 4. Put x equal to y plus h equal to y plus 3 and suppose that f of x then becomes q naught y raised to 4 plus q 1 y cube plus q 2 y square plus q 3 y plus q 4. Now, y equal to x minus 3, hence we have the identity p naught x raised to 4 plus p 1 x cube plus p 2 x square plus p 3 x plus p 4 equal to q naught into x minus 3 raised to 4 plus q 1 into x minus 3 whole cube plus q 2 into x minus 3 whole square plus q 3 into x minus 3 plus q 4. Hence, to find q 4, q 3 etcetera, we divide f of x successively by x minus 3 and the last quotient is q naught and is obviously equal to p naught equal to 2. The first line is the coefficients 2 minus 1 minus 2 5 minus 1. The second line is by the first step of Horner's process, we obtain 6, 15, 13 and 132. Adding, we obtain 5, 13, 44, 131 equal to Q4. The second step gives the value 6, 33, 130H. Adding, 11, 46, 182 equal to Q3. The third step gives the value 6, 51. Adding, we obtain 17, 97 equal to Q2. The fourth step gives 6, adding we obtain Q1 equal to 23 and Q0 equal to P0 equal to 2. Hence, the required equation is 2x raised to 4 plus 23x cube plus 97x square plus 182x plus 131. We state some results without giving proof. Theorem 3. If f of x is a polynomial and f of a and f of b are of opposite signs, then one root of the equation f of x equal to 0 must lies between a and b. A special case is shown in figure 1. Theorem 4. If the expressions f of a and f of b have opposite signs, an odd number of roots of f of x equal to 0 will lie between a and b, and if f of a and f of b have the same sign, either no roots or an even number of roots will lie between a and b. Now, let us summarize the session. In this session, we have illustrated some methods for solving a reciprocal equation. We have described Newton's method of approximation to find approximate roots of a given polynomial equation. A discussion on Horner's process is also made. Before moving to the next session, try to solve the given questions. 1. Give one of the properties of a reciprocal equation. 2. Find the equation whose roots are the roots of the equation x raised to 4 minus 5x cube plus 7x square minus 4x plus 5 equal to 0 diminished by 2. 3. Find the equation whose roots are the roots of the equation x raised to 4 minus 5x cube plus 7x square minus 4x plus 5 equal to 0 increased by 7. 4. Transform the equation x raised to 4 plus 20x cube minus 143x square plus 430x plus 462 equal to 0 into an equation lacking the second term. Thank you for watching this session. See you next time. Until then, bye.